Hey students, so now we are going to learn a new concept of engineering mathematics which is called as Simpson's 3/8 rule. So, the first question is what is Simpson's 3/8 rule and why do we use the Simpson's 3/8 rule? So, let me tell you that whenever we have definite integration, so we can evaluate that definite integration by using the Simpson's 3/8 rule. So it is one of the statistical method, or I'll say the numerical method, to get the value of definite integration. Now, to get the answer of definite integration by using the Simpson 3/8 rule, we must know the subintervals between the endpoints. So let's take a case. Let's say I have integration from a to b f of x dx. So if I know the subintervals between a to b, then we can get the value of this integration by using Simpson's 3/8 rule. So basically, we generally use this rule whenever the evaluation of integration is difficult or which is giving us some complicated answer. So in such cases, this method is very useful. So guys, what is the formula, or what is that numerical method formula to get the answer of integration? So it is like 3h by 8. So since it is 3/8 rule, we have 3 upon 8 with this h. So we also have seen a rule called as Simpson's 1/3 rule. So when we have 1/3 rule, we say it is 1 upon 3h, and for 3/8 rule we call it as 3 upon 8h. Next, x plus 2t plus 3r. Now you must be thinking, what is x, t and r? So let's understand one symbol. So let's understand one symbol sequentially. So here I'll say where h equal to, it is the difference between subintervals. So guys, here I'll show you. So let's say this is the value of x, that is from a to b. So here I'll say, let's say x is a, first value is a, and let's say the last value is b. So in between this we'll take certain values of x. So let's call this first value as x0. So here we will be taking x1, then x2, then x3, then x4 and x5, and let's call this value as x6. So these values of x, whatever is the difference between any two values of x, is always constant, or it must be constant, and that difference is called as h. So h is nothing but the constant difference between any two subintervals. Next, what is x? So x is nothing but sum of extreme ordinates. Now what is meaning of extreme ordinates? So ordinate is nothing but the y coordinate. So guys, for each value of x, we are gonna find out the value of f of x, and that value of f of x is nothing but our y. So this first value will be y0, y1, y2, y3, then y4, y5, and the last value will be y6. So here we will get the value of y for each and every corresponding value of x, and these values of y are called as ordinates. So sum of extreme ordinates means, in this case, the sum of y0 and y6, so extreme values, that will be called as x. Now what is t? So it is sum of the ordinates which are multiple of 3. Or I would say sum of multiple of 3 ordinates. Now guys, see here, in x I have considered the sum of extreme ordinates, so y0 and y6 is gone. Now out of the remaining 5 ordinates, we have to just consider the ordinates which are multiple of 3. So here I can see it is y3. So sum of all the ordinate which are multiple of 3, but since we have only the single ordinate, the value of y3 will be copied here. But let's say we have y6, y9, y12. So these multiple of 3 ordinates, we have to add it all the values, or add all the values of this my ordinates, and we will call it as t. And then in the end r, so it is nothing but sum of remaining ordinates. So guys, now it's very simple. See here, with x I have removed these extreme ordinates, with t I have removed the multiple of 3 ordinates, and after that whatever ordinates are remaining, we'll add all the ordinates and we'll call it as r. So by putting the value of h, x, t and r in this formula, we can get the value of the definite integration by using Simpson 3/8 rule. But guys, before using this rule, there is one condition which is mandatory and we have to follow it. And that condition is, whenever we are taking the intervals, the number of intervals must be the multiple of 3. Or the if you want to remember, you can remember like this: the last value of this ordinate must be multiple of 3. So here, as we have y6 or 6 in the end, 6 is the multiple of 3, it will be accepted. Or we can have y3 as the last ordinate, we can have y9 or y12 or y15 and so on. So you can observe that all these ordinates are multiple of 3. So this last value you have to take care of, and it must be the multiple of 3. So by using the Simpson's 3/8 rule, we can solve the definite integration in multiple numericals. And now we'll learn the numericals in the next video. So I'm sure that you like this video and you want to learn the more numericals. So you can log into ekeeda.com to learn the more numericals on Simpson's method as well as the other concepts of engineering mathematics. So stay tuned and let's see everybody in the next video for the numerical based on Simpson's 3/8 rule. Thank you very much.